guys, it's Haff. I am back in, and this is going to be my July makeup basket. So as usual, I will put on my makeup, chat about a few things, you know, that kind of too flicky. The theme for July is Christmas in July, which is ironic because Christmas is not my favourite time of the year, any time of year. But anyway, I'm starting with the AOA Wonder Skin Primer. This is a silicon primer. Those people who don't like silicon primers, well, it's probably not the one for you, even if it is only like a dollar. So lots of green makeup this month, and some red, and some gold, and white, but mainly green. I have a lot of green in my green stuff in my collection. For foundation this month, I'm using the Maybelline Fit Me Dewy and Smooth in 115 Ivory. I went and picked up a new one of these the other day when they had 40 or 50% off cosmetics at Priceline. It is fast becoming my go-to foundation because it doesn't look terrible on my skin, my crusty old skin, and it applies quickly and easily with my fish brush, which has become my favourite way to apply foundation, mainly because it is so much quicker. It's about as quick as it is when I use my hands, basically. And when I use my hands, I really just slop them. So, there's that. So, I am filming this on the 31st of July, the end of the financial year. Mainly because I'm in the middle of studying for exams. My two exams that I have are on Wednesday and Thursday. So the 3rd and the 4th. So, yeah, I'm trying to fit this in with making sure I'm prepared. I think I'm about as prepared as I'm going to get, quite frankly. I think I have as much of a handle on it as I'm going to get. Four exams, honestly. I wasn't doing too badly anyway. I got my results back for my last assignments of the course, and both of those were distinctions, so that was a nice lead up to exams. Got credit the first time around, distinction the second, which is what they kind of expect, is that there'll be some growth. I'm using for concealer the Maybelline Fit Me in 05 Ivory. I bought another one of these when I bought another one of the Fit Me foundation, because this is my preferred concealer. It's pretty much the only one that doesn't go orange underneath my eyes, or like darken underneath my eyes. I'm just going to let that sit there for a little bit while I do something about my brows. I'm using the Anastasia Beverly Hills this month in caramel. It's like their duo one. I hit pan on this last year. The brush that I normally use, which is the ABH brush, I actually dropped it down behind my computer, and in order to get it, I would need to pull my computer out completely. So I'm using a different brush. And I really liked the Anastasia one, so a bit annoyed. But it's alright. goes from having no eyebrows to having eyebrows. Blend out under the eyes. Both hands have quite short nails on them at the moment, as you can see. I'm going to actually use them and not poke myself in the eye. I mean, I still use them anyway, even when they're super long, but at the moment they're short. And only one hand, of course, has nail polish on. This is actually gel polish. I was mucking around trying something. If you watched my last review for Born Pretty, I was playing with spider gel, and I had a couple of questions about whether it got on, like how badly it got on the skin, and the removal of it on the skin before curing. So I decided to actually, on the middle finger, I used spider gel on that. And honestly, I got very little on the skin, considering it's the first time I've ever used it on an actual person. I was actually kind of surprised. I thought it would make like a huge mess, honestly. But it mainly sticks to the nail and not so much to the skin. I'm just setting under my eye with my Artist Selection HD palette. Honestly, it didn't really get on my skin at all, and the little bit that did get on my skin came off so easily with just a small brush and some rubbing alcohol. It was really not an issue at all. So, yeah. So for those of you who are curious after watching that video, that is the answer to that question, is yes, a little bit will probably get on your skin. It's the nature of the product, but it's quite easy to clean off, and less will get on your skin than you're probably expecting. I mean, I guess if you wanted to use a latex barrier, you probably could. I just don't really see the point, because it was so little, and yeah, just swipe with alcohol and it comes off. That's the thing, is if you're using gels, the way you clean them up is with rubbing alcohol, so like isopropyl alcohol, not nail polish remover. So if you're doing anything with gels, make sure you've got isopropyl alcohol. Okay, now I'm going to go back to the brows just briefly. I'm going to add some extender brow. I really have very little hair, and what I do have is quite erratic in nature. So every little bit helps, quite frankly. And over the top of that, I am using Rimmel Brow This Way in Blonde, which is just a tinted brow gel. Morta sort of tried to tame some of the flyaway he has. I've actually got one on his eyebrow that is not playing ball, but you can't really see it from there. Although you can probably see the bit that I smudged on my eyebrow. Okay, so for contour, I'm going to use my Haffina, which is this one right here. It's not actually in the project. I don't don't have a contour in the project. It's just what I'm using. It's part of Astralis's. That's where this came from. It's part of their build your own palette type range. I actually have two of them because I got one in a beauty box bag thing that they did. You know, spend X amount of dollars and we'll give you a bag of cosmetics, and just happen to have Haffina in it as well, which is fine because it's the contour shade I would use anyway, because it's the right kind of tone for pale skin. Yes, I'm actually using the camera thing as a mirror. I do have a mirror down here, but they both work. I don't contour all the time. Sometimes I do, sometimes I don't. When I'm doing videos, I usually contour only because I can. So I have a choice of two different blushes. I have this one here, which is from Maybelline. It's called Brick Rose, which I depotted donkeys ago. And I also have Playful Plum, like, you know, plum pudding. Brick Roses, because fireplaces and Christmas. Playful Plum from Revlon. I got this from Tamara J. It's quite a bold purpley. That's actually the one I'm going to use at the back of my cheekbone. As you can see, it is quite strong. It would probably look absolutely gorgeous on a really deep skin tone. That's one of those ones that someone like me just needs a little tiny bit. And then I'm actually going to go into the Brick Rose and kind of do the front part and blend that a little bit using the same brush. So, because this is a very natural tone, helps tone it down just a little. This side looks so much darker. Looks very bold at the moment. I have a choice of two different highlighters. One of them is probably technically not a highlighter. I think it's supposed to be a very light bronzer, which is this one here. It's called Golden Glow. It's from Girly Cosmetics. And the other one I have is the Daybreak Ombre, which is really hard to see the ombre. It's from Models Prefer. This is in First Light. So, this is super glittery, but I don't know how impactful it is. We might put a bit of both on and see what we think. I can see it in my mirror, not so much. Got a bit more punch to it. I do like a decent highlighter, and I probably use far too much of it, but I don't care. Highlighter is actually the one thing that I've managed to pan, and I've panned two of them, and hit pan in a third, so yeah. Highlighter is one of those products that most people are like, I never can pan a highlighter, and I'm over here like, I can pan them babies without even trying. Maybe it's because most of the highlighters I've had are not the best. So you tend to need to use more in order to get a nice glow going. Of course, if that's the kind of thing you like. No one says you have to. It's personal preference. I'm just going to give that a bit of a blend. I haven't contoured my jawline or anything. It's not going to make any difference. It's still going to be chubby. Nothing's changing that. Okay, that is basically it for my face makeup. Okay, I forgot to turn the camera on. Okay, so all I've done so far is I've put white eye primer in the LA Girl Pro Primer in white. And then from my Lorac palette, I used Cashmere, which is this one here. I'm also going to use this month Merlot, which is this one here, and Caviar, which is the black one. I don't know if I'm using them today, I'm just using them this month. And I also have to choose from Chili Pepper from Girl Cosmetics and Counterfeit, and then Envy and Houdini from Makeup Geek. And I have the Gold Digger pigment from Glamour Doll Eyes and Family Secret. And what I said was it wasn't recording, is that I almost didn't use this because, which I'm using a Gold Digger as my initial crease colour. It is a loose pigment. So it's one of those things that it's kind of hard when you see stuff happening in the makeup community, in the beauty community, that you don't agree with, and the only real power you have is that of consumer power. which is to not support brands that you don't agree with things that are going on. And it's like when a company is closing down and you own their product, it's you're not really going to be supporting them anymore anyway, because they're not in, still in production. So it's, I think it's slightly different than the other way around. It's like, I love the stuff that Jeffree Star has been putting out. Like, I really want the Jawbreaker. Like, I really love the whole idea of the collection. However, I don't really like Jeffree Star himself. I find him kind of irritating. And not even because of his behaviours that are basically quite inappropriate. I just find him irritating. I find a lot of the big name influencers kind of irritating. Which is why I don't watch most of them. And yeah, I was just kind of like, you know, much as I am inspired by his like makeup and his palettes, I'm just blending the edge out with some more Gold Digger. You know, much as I'm inspired by that stuff and I think it looks really cool, I'm not going to spend my coin on it because I don't like a lot of the things that he stands for. One of the ones that got me the most with him, I'm just going back into Merlot, we're just gonna build it up a bit more, is there was an incident about dope smoking, and he was quite nasty to a young up-and-coming influencer who made some comment about the whole dope smoking thing. She comes from a country where that's illegal, and it's, I think if you're an international influencer, you need to be sensitive to the fact that not everybody is entitled to do the things that you're entitled to do due to the country that they live in. And having a go at someone who is like, I don't like that, is like bogus, man, because in her country, that's not okay. You're not allowed to do that. In Australia, unless you have medical clearance, which is really hard to get, by the way, it's illegal to be in possession of marijuana. It's like, there's no two ways about it. You can end up in some serious trouble. And, you know, these young Australian kids are seeing influencers like Jeffree Star sitting there promoting it, and whilst it's fine for him to do it, those kids could end up in some serious trouble in this country if they're caught doing the same thing. And I think that influencers have a responsibility to their audience and understand that not all of their audience is based in the same country they are. I'm just going to take some caviar and put that in the outside corner. I understand that other countries, they have the right to do these things, and they probably think that, you know, Australia, New Zealand, whatever, are really behind. We have some very strong rules about a lot of things here that other countries don't have, and, you know, not everybody in Australia agrees with marijuana being illegal. A lot of people would like to have access, or more easily have access to medical marijuana. It's just not something that is easily obtainable here. There is a program where if you can get your doctor to get on this particular register, he can import medicinal marijuana like CBD. But getting doctors to agree is actually really difficult, and there are very few doctors on this register. Most of them are eastern states. I don't live in the eastern states of Australia. I live in South Australia. So it's just a different... We just have different laws here, different rules here. I'm going to put a little bit of caviar underneath the eye. By a little bit, I clearly mean a lot. Because that went on thicker and harder than I was expecting. That's alright. And then... I'm going to take some of cashmere. Have two cream eyeshadows that I can use this month. I have white gold from City Colour, and I have the Astralis Guns and Rose Petals. I'm going to use Guns and Rose Petals. If I can find a brush that I want to use. I'm just going to take the brush that I had, the caviar on, and just go back over that edge. I have a choice of a couple of eyeliners. I have ordinary black eyeliner from Le Cura, the Photo Fit. I have a couple of pencil eyeliners. I have a green one and I have a black one. But I'm going to use on my top line the NYX Glam Liner Aqualux. It's supposed to be waterproof. This is in Glam Golden. Not going to do a wing because I think there's enough going on at the moment. I'm going to tight line top and bottom with the Model Co. black eyeliner, which was the one I was referring to as my black eyeliner. This is in my finished 20 and 2020 project, I believe. It's not the blackest black pencil. Does the job. Sort of. And then I'm going to take a little tiny bit of Family Secret. And I'm just going to put that mascara I'm going to be using is the Peacock Flare from CoverGirl, because it's one of the ones that I have open. I remember listening to a conversation on, I don't know if it was a conversation, but somewhere where people were talking about whether you used the same hand to apply your mascara, or whether you used alternate hands. It's like the same hand that was on that side. And I was like, I think I used the same hand, and yes, I used the same hand. So that is pretty much the eye look. I am going to zoom out and finish off my makeup. I'm just going to add another coat of mascara because I always do too. Self in eye. Do not recommend. That's the only problem with this particular type of mascara wand, is it's that like hard, like it's soft, but it's kind of spiky plastic and or rubber or whatever, and it's unpleasant when you hit yourself in the eyeball. So, on to lips. So, I have two lip liners. I have the L'Oreal Magic Nude Clear one. And then I have my Besame double-ended one, which I used in a recent makeup tutorial. I have this lipstick from NYX, which is Wicked. One of the Wicked Lippies. This is in Treachery. It's kind of like a dark foresty green. I have, from Bite Beauty, I have Pomegranate, which is a red. From Maybelline, I have a Bold Matte in number 4, which is more of a strawberry red. I have the NYX Liquid Suede in Kitten Heels. As you can see, lots of red this month. This one is more of a true red. Then I have the Haughty lip gloss in Give. Basically just a red lip gloss. And then for some fun, we have the Electroshock lip gloss from Revlon, from the Spider-Man collection from years ago, which has got some colour on the end of the wand from the last time I used it. But basically it's sort of like green with a bit of a red reflect in it. And lastly, I have Tinseltown from Revlon, which is just a basically clear, again, it's got some colour on the end of the doe foot. It's just a sparkly lip gloss. Just because. So I'm going to line my lips with one end of the Besame. Which one am I going to use? I'm going to line it with this one. And I'll probably fill in as well. I think I'm going to go with Kitten Heels, actually. It's going to be a very bright lip, but... And then I'm going to finish that off with just a little bit of the Tinseltown. Just in the center of the lip. Is the final look from this month's makeup basket. I don't know what I will be wearing, but this is one potential look. So if you want to subscribe, click the little bell down the bottom, leave me a thumbs up if you like makeup look type videos and makeup baskets, and leave me a comment down below. I try to respond to all comments, and I'll see you in my next video. See ya.